Call it the Oxford of the East, the historical city of Shivaji, or whatever you may please. Pune has this laid-back attitude that's addictive, and the cool breeze here will never let you go. So if you're driving down here for a weekend, come here to study, or just want to know more about the city, here are 10 local Puneri places that you ought to try out. First up is Amriteshwar Pohe at the Null Stop Signal. Even at 4 in the morning, this place is buzzing with excitement. With tons of bikes parked outside this empty road, Kande Pohe is the hottest selling item with garma garam chai at Amriteshwar Pohe. Meet the busy man that runs this place. सुबह 4 बजे क्यों चलाते हैं? तो अभी 4 बजे इतना भीड़ क्यों होता है यहाँ पे?
इतना भीड़ होता है वो कॉलेज के वजह से.
Honestly, I've never come here before because I couldn't ever bring myself to get up at 4 in the morning and come and eat this pohe. But now that I'm here, I can actually see why people are actually addicted to this pohe because it's really simple but it's really kick-ass is the word. And there are all these newspaper walas, the entire road is empty and you can only see a crowd around this particular shop. So when you come to Pune, you should definitely try this one. I mean, you will have to get up early in the morning because it's only about there for half an hour and then it gets over. But you should definitely try this.
Next up is the Good Luck Cafe at the Good Luck Chowk. This place is nearly 100 years old and people come here for their bun maska and chai and their yummeliciously affordable and spicy keema pav. So let's meet some of its oldest diners and let's see what they have to say.
And when we came, we were coming in 70s, that time chicken masala, it was hardly 6 rupees and mutton masala 3.5. So that chicken taste is still there.
We are coming here since 1950. The few, one or two restaurants where we used to get non-veg earlier during the 50s and the 60s. We know when lots of things were outside there, the footpath is there. Yeah. There we used to have the chameli trees over there. Chameli flowers were also following on the table. So wherever the friends say, where are you meeting today evening? We say, chameli ke mande ve thale. We used to come and sit over there.
Okay.
At that time, tea was 1 anna, that is 6 paisa at that time.
Wow.
And samosa was also 1 anna.
So what's the secret? Let's find out from the man himself.
Hi, I'm Kasim Yakshi. I'm one of the partners for Cafe Good Luck. Only change is in the quality of the mutton that I get. Otherwise, the basic masala, the way it is prepared, has not changed over the years. Secondly, it's because we try and maintain the quality as much as possible. Three, we try and keep the price down as much as possible so that it's affordable for all walks of life.
So next time you're coming to Pune, you should definitely plan a trip to Good Luck Cafe. Now it's time to tease the sweet tooth with Pune's favorite handmade ice cream, Sujata Mastani. You can just Zomato the closest Sujata Mastani in your area. So who started making this Mastani? And how is it different from ice cream?
So my father started it in a very small place and he used to prepare with his hands. That was the pot ice cream, which was a wooden pot with ice and salt. And he used to churn with his hands.
The best part about this ice cream is that the flavor is very different. It's not like any other ice cream that I've ever tasted. It's really creamy. And the texture of this ice cream and the flavor is totally unique. Like, it's really non-stop eating.
इधर का जो फ्लेवर है टेस्ट है बाकी इतने मस्त नहीं है पुणे में, लेकिन और में किसमें इतना ये नहीं है, स्पेशल है.
इसकी टेस्ट मुझे इसलिए पसंद है क्योंकि ये बहुत ही नेचुरल आइसक्रीम लगता है.
इसकी टेस्ट जो है ना मेरे को किधर भी नहीं मिली, इसलिए मैं इधर ही आता हूँ.
मैं बचपन से आती हूँ यहाँ पे, जब मैं 2 साल की थी तब से आती हूँ यहाँ पे.
They have it in the morning, they have it in the afternoon, they have it in the evening.
So which flavor mastani should I try then?
Chocolate, choco chip and mango. Mango mastani.
Pista.
Mango flavor सबसे favorite है.
Mango मेरा favorite है.
Mango flavor मेरा भी favorite है. और क्योंकि सबने बोला कि मैंगो मस्तानी यहाँ की बेस्ट है और इतने सारे लोगों ने मुझसे कहा कि वो मैंगो मस्तानी खाने से ज़्यादा मस्तानी आते हैं, तो इसलिए मैंने डिसाइड किया कि मैं मैंगो मस्तानी ही खाऊंगी.
दिस लिप स्मैकिंग लेंटिल प्रिपरेशन विद क्रंची फरसान इज कॉल्ड मिसल. यू गेट द बेस्ट मिसल इन पुणे. And you get the best Puneri misal at Bedekar's. तो इस मिसल का सीक्रेट क्या है?
क्या सीक्रेट होगा? कुछ सीक्रेट नहीं.
कोई
सीक्रेट नहीं.
तो फिर सबसे ज्यादा एक्सपीरियंस होता है कि बेडेकर जी के पास ही लोग आते हैं.
हाथ का कमाल है, कुछ बाकी कुछ नहीं.
Eating in Pune and no misal pao? You must be kidding me. There's a really interesting story about how Pune's Lakshmi Narayan Chioda came about.
1955 में पिताजी ने शुरू किया और पिताजी का नाम ही लक्ष्मी नारायण था. उन्होंने पिताजी 1920 से लेकर 1935 तक 15 साल तक पूरे देश का दौरा किया, विदेश भी गए. विदेश में बदनाम में लक्ष्मी भी रहती थी, अफगानिस्तान में काबुल में रहे, पेशावर में रहे, कराची में रहे, सब जगह का टेस्ट कर जो ये था, इसलिए हर जगह के लोग.
So the flavor of this chioda is really the flavor of India. Why Lakshmi Narayan? Why not any other chioda?
ये इसका टेस्ट अलग है, इसमें ड्राई फ्रूट ज़्यादा होता है, टेस्ट अलग है.
टेस्ट अलग है.
ऑयली कम है.
अच्छा. There's no place like Tiranga if rustic, spicy Maharashtrian food is what you're craving for. With dishes like gavran chicken and yummy Maharashtrian mutton biryani, this place will make you lick your fingers.
I'm a regular customer of Tiranga past 8 to 10 years. I also own a restaurant. But I'm a big fan of this place.
The first time I'm coming to Pune and my cousin has invited, so go to Tiranga and we have a masala dish. Chicken masala. I'm enjoying like anything.
Wanna know what the yummiest dishes here are?
So you have mutton biryani out here. It just gets cooked once in a day, like twice. Once in the afternoon for lunch and one at night for dinner in the evening. Once it gets over, it's over. We can't make it again for the rest of the day. So basically, it's like, as I said, it's all fresh. You don't have leftovers. It's very simple. You just eat with your hands. You have the Kolhapuri chicken fry. It's basically chicken chunks with fry gravy. It's spicy and it has a thick gravy in it. That's gavran chicken handi. It's basically gavran chicken, which is desi murgi. It's smaller in size but very tasty. You won't find much meat on it, but the juice and the flavor of the chicken, it's very different from the normal broiler. And that's the specialty of, you know, Tiranga there, gavran chicken.
Isn't it amazing how many varieties and avatars of a simple peda chitle offers? Chitle is a famous sweet shop which offers many, many pedas and bhakarwadis. Sada peda, jumbo peda, sandwich peda, sugar dusted sakhri peda. The silky smooth kandi pedas, deep brown and grainy dharwadi pedas and everyone's favorite Rajkot pedas, which are made of milk instead of mawa. Pick up a box for yourself and you'll know why we Punekars just love to distribute pedas. An evening after work and you've got to stop by at Kalyan Bhel. Their sweet and spicy chutneys will surely make you dance with joy. This place is hygienic with perky chutneys that attracts big crowds. Custom made bhel for your taste buds in Pune is sure to impress the global desi. Cakes, cookies and chips. No Pune party is ever going to be complete without Kayani goodies and Budhani wafers. So get in that line and make sure you grab a big bag of Shrewsbury biscuits and mawa cake before anybody else gets there. Because you see that line? You're not going to be able to taste any of that if you don't hurry. While in Pune, we have a simple rule. No chips, no movie. No chips, no cricket match. So while you're in Pune, be a Punekar and try Budhani chips. Did you think that was all Pune has to offer? No way. There's Jhunka Bhakar from Singhar Fort, Thali Peet from Shabri, there's also Sabudana Vadas from Vaishali. There's so much more to explore in this city. So keep reading, keep eating, and keep sharing on foodmantra.in.